Yes, the chapter. Yes, the chapter Packing, written by Jerome K. Jerome. But it's an extract from the novel Three Men in a Boat. So it's about how three friends decide to go for a boating trip. And after this decision, the biggest task they have to do is that they have to do the packing for the trip. So when they have all gathered the things around them, when everything has been piled around, when it is the task of doing the packing, then first of all, the biggest mistake they make is they think packing is very easy. So that's why the narrator offers himself to do the packing. He says, I would pack, I will pack. And the other friends, how they will become relaxed when he would be doing packing. And first of all, you'll see whether this narrator will be able to do the perfect packing or not. If not, then when the other person would come, will he be able to do? So the very first humor is the way the narrator would offer himself to be the master of packing. Okay, let's see. Sometimes when you say like, I can do this, it's so easy. And when you are not able to do it, then what happens? And another humor is when the narrator will be doing the packing, then how the other friends will be behaving. How does it feel when you are working and your other partners are not working? When you are at home, when you are doing some work and your sibling, your brother, sister is sitting and relaxing, how do you feel? How do you feel? Very bad. And your problem is not that you are working. Your problem becomes that your sibling is not working. And the same happens in classroom also. When you people are doing some work for the class and the others are just sitting and munching chips, you feel so bad, like we are doing so much of work and others are just relaxing. Especially when the classroom decoration competition comes. You know, 10 children out of 50, they work so hard for the class. The other 40, you know, what they do after the competition is over? Have we got some prize? And the moment they come to know, they're like, no prize. Yeah, I knew this. Such bad charts you made. Or they've start telling you the mistakes. It's not good. Do it again. So you feel so bad when the others who are not doing anything tell you the mistakes. Isn't it? So let's see what happens here. I'm going to start the chapter now. So I said I would pack. I rather pride myself on my packing. Packing is one of those many things that I feel I know more about than any other person living. So in the very beginning, we get the humor. Narrator is proud of his packing skills. He thinks like no one else is as good in packing as he is. What's the page number? Page number is 82. Latecomers, kindly organize yourself without any disturbance. So I rather pride myself on my packing. Packing is one of those things that I feel I know more about than any other person living. It surprises me myself sometimes how many such things there are. So see the humor? The narrator says, like, even I get surprised at how many things I am good at. Like, I'm good at so many things. I get surprised. I impressed the fact upon George and Harris and told them that they had better leave the whole matter entirely to me. He told his friends that leave everything on me. Leave it on me. You know? So they fell into the suggestion with a readiness that had something uncanny about it. Uncanny, strange, mysterious. So the narrator said, okay, leave it on me. I'll do the packing. And the others, they said, okay, and they left. And this was very strange. When there is something very big to do and you say, okay, I'll manage, you relax. And you expect the other person to say, don't worry, I'll be with you. No, 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 it is such a big task. I'll be helping you. But those friends didn't say anything like this. They simply said, okay. So that was uncanny for the narrator. You are to answer MCQs. Try to find the reason behind everything. What was narrator proud of? His packing skills. What did he tell his friends? That he would do everything on his own. Why did he say like this? To impose his superiority. Why did he say like this? Because he wanted to prove that he was doing it better than many other people. Did the other friends agree with him easily? Yes. They said, okay. They readily accepted his suggestion. What was the suggestion? What was the suggestion, Harshit? What was the suggestion? If we don't have the book, we can listen. No. Our ears, 2 ears. So what was the suggestion? Manavit. Yes, the suggestion was by the narrator that he would do the packing. Okay, that he would do the packing entirely on his own. And his friends agreed. Why did they agree, Lavanya? Okay. Sometimes when you say, when somebody tells you, okay, I'll do it everything. I'll do everything. Don't worry. Then sometimes you feel, okay, start doing it. We'll see whether you are able to do it or not. Sometimes meaning is this, and we readily give up. So the friends also readily gave up because they knew that narrator will not be able to do it. Okay. And secondly, yes, they were lazy also. And you will see like one of these, basically all of them are lazy, but one is extremely lazy. Try to find out who that person is. They fell into the suggestion with a readiness that had something uncanny about it. What is uncanny? Strange. What was strange about the about their readiness? That it was not expected that they would say okay to the narrator so easily, but they said so. George spread himself over the easy chair. What does it mean? He spread himself over the easy chair. He got comfortable on an easy chair. He lay there. And Harris cocked his legs on the table. And what did Harris do? How he sat? He cocked his legs on the table. Got it? This was hardly what I intended. Yes, look at the book. Look at the book. This was hardly what I intended. What is intended? Desired. Desired. Wished. This was not what I had wished. What was not wished by the narrator? Yes, Veda, you tell. Aapke. Number one, they said okay. And number two, they were in a comfortable position. Okay, that is most annoying thing in the world when you are working and your other friends are relaxing. That's not very, very, that's not at all tolerable. Okay, so that the narrator says, this was not at all I had desired. This was hardly what I intended. Means that it was not what I had desired. What I had meant, of course, was that I should boss the job and Harris and George should potter about under my directions. What is the meaning of potter about? to do some important or unimportant things. Potter about means doing unimportant things. So when the narrator said, like, leave entirely upon me, I will manage, he wanted to say that he will be bossing over the job. He will be the boss. He will be telling them, like, now, okay, bring that, keep it here, put that there. So he will be the boss, and the two friends will be working like his subordinates. This is what he had intended. But what happened? He had to do everything on his own. He was not the boss. Now he had become a slave, because the friends were lying on their couches very comfortably. So they were not pottering about. Okay? Sometimes when your papa starts doing some work, he says, okay, main karwata hun kaam sare. What happens then? Father sits down, and who basically does the work? You. It might be happening in many families. It usually happens. Even mothers do this. You know, main karwati hun sare kaam. Then what happens? Chalo, bring that. Beta, go there and bring something over here. Yeah, keep the chair like this. Yeah. So who is the boss? Mother. Who is the worker? You, right? So this is what was expected by the narrator, but it did not happen. Yes. Okay, we'll carry it on tomorrow. Yes, read the whole chapter carefully, okay?